Measuring shoulder flexion, patient can be in a seated or supine position. Axis of the goniometer will be on the greater tubercle of the humerus, the movement arm along the lateral epicondyle, and the stationary arm parallel with the torso. Rachel, if you could, bring your arm into full flexion for me. We're looking at 170 degrees of flexion. Measuring shoulder extension, patient can be in a seated or prone position for this. You want the axis of your goniometer to be on the greater tubercle of the humerus, your movement arm lined up with the lateral epicondyle, and your stationary arm lined up with the torso of the body. Rachel, if you could, bring back your shoulder as far back as you can. Here we're looking at 48 degrees of extension. Measuring shoulder external rotation, patient will be in a supine position, shoulder and elbow at 90 degrees while being supported. The axis of your goniometer will be on the olecranon. Movement arm will follow the styloid process of the ulna, and the stationary arm will be perpendicular with the ceiling. Rachel, if you could, perform full external rotation for me. Let me make sure that's lined up on the styloid, perpendicular, so it'll look something like that. And for this, we're looking at 95 degrees of external rotation. Measuring shoulder internal rotation. Patient will be in a supine position, shoulder and elbow at 90 degrees. Just like external rotation, we're going to line the axis of the goniometer with the olecranon and the movement arm following the styloid process of the ulna with the stationary arm perpendicular with the ceiling. Now, Rachel, if you could, perform internal rotation for me. Now, I want to show you before I measure what to look out for. Now, if I push down on the shoulder right here, push down on the forearm, I mean, you can see the shoulder being hiked, and that is compensation allowing more internal rotation at this joint than it actually has. So just look out for that. Make sure that when you perform this, there's no hiking of the shoulder. So what you do is you find the position right before the shoulder starts getting hiked, and that is where you measure it at. So about right there. Axis on the olecranon, styloid process of the ulna, stationary arm perpendicular to the ceiling. We are looking here at about 72 degrees of internal rotation. Measuring shoulder abduction, patient will be in a seated or supine position. Just keep in mind that the supine position, gravity is eliminated, while in a seated position, they will be working against gravity. So be consistent whatever way you do it. To perform this, you want the axis of your goniometer to be on the humeral head, the stationary arm running parallel with the body, and the movement arm running along the shaft of the humerus. Now, when your patient performs abduction, you want to make sure that their thumb leads the way and that their palm is towards the ceiling, just like this. So Rachel, if you could, perform full abduction for me. Thank you. So have that on the humeral head, running alongside the shaft of the body. And we're looking at 175 degrees.